To do adequate justice to the chronicling of the history of the evolution of contemporary politics in Nigeria, the name of the Right Honorable Titi Oseni will be mentioned as the first female speaker of Ogun State House of Assembly. Indeed, from June 2003 to May 15, 2008, the Right Honorable Titi Oseni's image loomed large in the horizon in the political firmament of Ogun State of Nigeria as the number three most important personality in the state. A position in which she acquitted herself creditably and contributed immensely to the development of Ogun State, thereby becoming a shining beacon of hope, not only for the women, but also for people who became convinced that Nigerian politics is, after all, not as bad as it's been portrayed, and so joined the fray. The second of the last child of our mother's four children, from parents who were in the medical profession, but also involved in a lot of humanitarian services, the Right Honorable Titi Oseni's interest in politics began to take root from the influence she drew from her parents. So when the opportunity opened for her to serve her people in Ogun State, she did not hesitate to lash in on it. Today, through dedicated service to the good people of Ogun State, the Right Honorable Titi Oseni has garnered a lot of goodwill and built a network of friends from the diverse divides of Nigeria, the economic, social, and political spheres.
I always thought that I would love to live by the sea, to travel the world alone and live more simply. I have no idea what's happened to that dream, 'cause there's really nothing left here to stop me. It's just a thought, only a thought. If my life is for rent and I don't learn to buy, well, I deserve nothing more than I get, 'cause nothing I have is truly mine. If my life is for rent and I,
this was glaringly evident at the black tie dinner organized to formally welcome Honorable Titi Oseni into the prestigious Golden League, which took place at the Civic Center, Victoria Island, Lagos, on Friday, 26 September 2014. Not even the very chaotic and nightmarish traffic that completely locked down movement from almost all sides of Lagos on that day could dampen the spirit and enthusiasm of friends, colleagues, and loved ones and family members who had all come to felicitate with Honorable Titi Oseni on that most glorious and auspicious chapter of our life. To demonstrate how far Honorable Titi Oseni reached out in that most exalted office of the Speaker of Ogun State House of Assembly, exactly 6 years after her tenure, every sector in the Gateway State, without any exception, registered a huge and robust attendance at the dinner. Our former colleagues in the legislative, executive, and judiciary arms of government, with whom Honorable Titi Oseni had dealings over the time, were there in very impressive numbers. This is indeed worthy of huge commendation, especially now that politics split allies who belonged in the same political camps into separate cleavages, in fact, turning some of them into sworn enemies. What must certainly have done it for Honorable Titi Oseni is her permanent disarming humility and respect which she accords everyone, no matter their status in life. So, at Honorable Titi Oseni's 50th birthday anniversary dinner, all the political tendencies collapsed under one roof of love for humanity. The Right Honorable Titi Oseni, who before taking a plunge into full-scale politics was in the fashion retailing and importation of computers as a major player in that sector, and the private sector was honored with the presence of our friends in that sector, and these included business moguls Molade Okoya-Thomas, Alhaji Razak Okoya, and in fact Justice Olusola Oguntade, among others. The fashionistas, as well as the Lagos, Ogun, Abuja, and Port Harcourt social circuits, led by Senator Florence Itagiwa, came out in large numbers to honor one of their own, not even occupying the plum office of Ogun State No. 3 citizen for 6 years, could change Honorable Titi Oseni's very quiet life, not one to seek undue publicity. In fact, she would rather operate silently. However, hitting the almighty 50 years mark, 2 years above 48, which is considered as a deadline for life expectancy in these parts, is more than a big deal. And so, the Right Honorable Titi Oseni for once let down her guards and really went to town real big to celebrate it. She entered the arena in company of her children and some family members and danced excitedly, exchanging pleasantries along the way, while others in the crowd also joined her in felicitation. The opening prayer was said by Mr. Tunde Lemo, Central Bank of Nigeria's former Deputy Director of Operations. This was followed by the opening remarks by the chairman of the event, Justice Olusola Oguntade, retired judge of the Supreme Court of Nigeria. In it, he congratulated the celebrant, the Right Honorable Titi Oseni, for successfully hitting the 50-year mark and wished her many more happy returns of the day. The retired Supreme Court judge advised the celebrant to look back at her life at 50, reflect thoroughly, and make amends where necessary as she marches forward with greater expectation with the challenges of life ahead, so that mistakes of the past will not be repeated.
Titi, we congratulate you once again and wish you very well. Now, I want to commit you to a test. Since it has pleased God to enable you to attain 50 years, it is now time for you to reflect, to look back over the years, identify areas where you think you've done exceptionally well. And depending on the government you form, if you think you've done very well, persist in doing well. If you think that somehow you fumbled, look back and correct the errors of the past. Against that ground, you now look to the future. I'm sure that in Jesus' name, it will be well with you. It is also time for you to pray that whichever height you may reach in life, then your children reach even higher life. The simple ladies and gentlemen, I want you to join me in saying together, happy birthday to our dear Titi. Are we ready?
Yes.
Titi, happy birthday. Once again, happy birthday. And a third time, happy birthday.
The cutting of the birthday cake was next, and the celebrant was joined by her children as she cut her cake.
At the mention of the last letter in the word Jesus. Are we ready?
Yes, sir.
Let somebody give me a A. An E.
E.
S.
S.
U.
U.
Another S.
S.
And that's S.
Jesus.
Yeah.
After that, there was what could be called a flurry of video and photo sessions, with a huge array of friends of the celebrant taking their turns to have a snapshot with the lady of the moment, the Right Honorable Titi Oseni, the first female speaker of Ogun State House of Assembly, who served in that capacity for 6 years. The toast of the celebrant was proposed, and there was singing and dancing as people cling glasses to the good health and success of the Right Honorable Titi Oseni. From then on, the celebrant went round the arena, taking every table up and dancing as they all joined in the celebration excitedly. The 50th birthday anniversary celebration program of the Right Honorable Titi Oseni ended with pure undiluted fun and dancing. Everyone, the old, the young, took to dancing, gyrating to music to express their heartfelt joy and felicitation with Honorable Titi Oseni on her attainment of that great milestone. May God, in His infinite mercies, bless the new golden Amazon of our time, the Right Honorable Titi Oseni.